There we go. Fish on. Hey guys and gals, and welcome to a first look at Fishing Planet with me, Mr. Moose. Y'all are probably sick about hearing me talk about this game and not actually seeing any gameplay from it. So today we're going to actually get to take a look at it. I was able to get into the closed beta over the weekend and have played maybe a couple of days now, just getting used to the game and getting everything kind of situated so I could do a video. And so now that I'm to that point, I thought we would go ahead, do a little gameplay, talk a little bit about the game. I'll go over what I like, what I dislike about the game, and you know, just basically give you guys a little look at it so you can see what it is and why I'm so excited about it versus that other fishing game that we were playing. So as you can see right off the bat, the graphics are great in this game. Just they've done a really great job. Now today I'm gonna fish in several different locations while I talk to you about the game. Right now we're in what is considered North Carolina, and fishing for a little bass, doing some largemouth bass fishing. I may change it up and do a little crappie fishing as well, but for right now we're doing bass. Now notice I talked about two species of fish right there together. Unlike that other fishing game, which only had one species of fish, this thing is loaded with fish, and that's the reason I love this game. First of all, it is set in the United States, so that means there is access to all the different fish types and species that you would have here in the States. Bass, crappie, bluegill, catfish, you've got rainbow trout, brown trout, cutthroat trout, steelhead trout, salmon. There's striper in the game. There are carp in the game as well, for those of you who just gotta have your carp fishing for some reason. But there's so many varieties of fish that you can fish for in here. I mean, they've even got pecan bass and just all kinds of different things in here. Crappie. They've got several different types of crappie. You got your regular crappie. You've got your black crappie, white crappie. I mean, the list goes on and on. They've done just a really great job with this game. And a wide variety of lure selection, reel selection, rod selection. Just really, really nice. You can overhead cast. You can pitch. Like if I, right now, I can just cast out my line. But the next time I could just pitch it if I wanted to pitch into a certain spot. So they've done a really great job with this game setting it up. It's so far ahead of where that other one is. And it is still in closed beta, like I said. But wow, what a game they've got here for you. The potential is unreal. And I hope you guys get as excited about it as I do. If you're any kind of avid fisherman, outdoor enthusiast, or even you're just an armchair angler, I think you're going to really like this game and have a lot of fun playing it. So let's get into the basics of the game while I fish a little bit here. And if I get distracted along the way, I please apologize. I might be all over the road on this just because I'm trying to play the game and think off the top of my head about the little things to talk about this game. So I got a fish on here, and just try and get him in. So I'm using a basically what would be considered a bucktail jig here in the States, and they call it just a bass jig in the game here, and fishing for largemouth, maybe some smallmouth, and let's get this guy landed real quick. Ah, trophy largemouth. Very nice. 5 pounds. That's a big boy. Nice. Alright, so let's get into the game and the fundamentals of the game and gameplay and all that good stuff. First thing you need to know is this is a free-to-play game. Free-to-win, play-to-win, however you want to phase it. Very much like your World of Tanks or World of Warships. Games like that, even a little bit like The Hunter, where you get the game, you don't pay anything for it, you just download it, put it on your computer, you set up an account, and you start playing. It's that simple. You're involved right off the bat, don't have to pay any kind of out-of-pocket expenses to get into the game. Now, unlike The Hunter, this thing is set up where you really can enjoy it without having to spend any money out of pocket. The Hunter got to kind of be a money grab, and it seemed like to really enjoy the game, you did have to actually spend some cash. This one, so far from what I'm seeing from the play structure, it really is a game that if you put in the time to grind up your XP or grind up your in-game currency, you can enjoy this game for hours and hours and hours, and you're just going to have a great time. If you're one of those impatient few who you need things immediately, you need a little, you can't wait to get the next gadget in game, you may have to shell a little bit of money out of your pocket to up your in-game currency or to up your in-game gold for premium things. But for the most part, this is a game that you can just really grind out XP and have a lot of fun on. So the economics of the game are, as I said, it's a play-to-win situation where as you play, each fish you catch gives you a little bit of XP. The more XP you get, the higher level you get. The higher level fisherman you get, the better gear you're able to get. And the better gear you get, the bigger fish you're able to catch. So it's just one of those progression games, just like everything else that's out there. You start off kind of catching small things, and then as you improve your skill and as you move up, you can catch bigger and better fish, which is going to require bigger and better gear, which requires a little bit of money, which requires that you grind out some of the lower level fish to get the XP and the gold and the money to able to afford that kind of gear. So how is the in-game currency set up? It's pretty straightforward. You catch a fish, and at the end of your trip, you sell your fish off and you make a little money. If I jump into the menu system here real quick and I come to my fish keeper, I've caught 4 largemouth bass so far. Now, you'll see each of the bass, their weight, their length, that sort of information, what jig I caught it on, what the conditions were. All that stuff's great, but what we're worried about is the reward right here. You'll see I got 13 XP for the fish, and I got $19 for the fish as well. Each one has a different value of how much currency you'll get for it, and as well as the XP. Of course, your bigger fish is going to give you more XP. There are 3 levels of fish in the game. You've got many a species, but within each species, there's a size fish. You've got your regular fish, which in this case is your largemouth bass. Then you have the larger fish, which is your trophy largemouth bass. And then some species have unique fish. And those unique fish are your big granddaddies of the waterway. They are the Goliaths that have been around for a while, and they pay off a little bit better. They actually pay gold. So, but again, some species have them, some species don't. I imagine that down the road they'll have uniques for each species, but right now only certain species have unique fish and pay off gold. But you still, you use gold and in-game cash to pay for things. Now, cash is not hard to come by, neither is the gold. You just gotta fish and catch the fish, and at the end of your trip sell them off, and it's pretty straightforward. The most essential tool you have to have in the game is a fish stringer. You have to get one right off the bat, that way you can actually keep your fish. So that at the end of your trip, you can sell it. Now, I'm using some, I keep referring to trip. When you fish and you come to the lake, each time you come to the lake is a trip. And a trip depends on what lake you're going into. I'm not going to get into that right now. A little bit later on, I'll jump into the menu system and I'll tell you about trips licenses, all that information, okay? But just what you need to know is that a trip consists of a day, all right? And so a day is basically in this game from about 5 a.m. till midnight. And at the end of that day, you can sell off your fish and you make money off of them. So that's how you get your currency in the game. You can do one-day trips, two-day trips, three-day trips. It's up to you, however long you want to spend it. Like, I'll give you a little tip on trips. When we get to talking about trips, trip cost, licenses, all that information, I'll give you some tips on how long to make your trip and everything else like that. Let's focus on the gameplay right now. So I've told you about the species of fish. I've told you about the sizes of the fish. How do you actually cast and catch the fish? Here's where there's a little bit of a difference between the previous fishing game and this one, where I wish this game was a little bit more like it. The other one was a little bit more interactive as far as how you cast and how you catch the fish. On the other one, you would use your mouse to move your rod around left and right and back and forward. You'd hold down a mouse key, pull back on the rod over your head, and then you push forward real quick and let go, and that was how you cast. It was very interactive on how you cast. This is more of an arcade style, or more to a click to throw type situation. Like if you've ever played some of the golf, PGA golf games and stuff, where you got to click once to start your backswing, click again to reach your apex, and then click again to hit the ball. Well, it's a little bit like that. You've got a power graph over on the side. When I click my left mouse button and hold it down, the power graph is going to start increasing. And then when I let off of my mouse button, it casts. So it's not as interactive as the other one was. But at the same time, it's a little more forgiving and a little bit more, I can be more accurate with my cast. So there's a toss-off. You can have the other one where you're more interactive with it, but you're very, until you upped your skill and you got really good at mastering the technique, you were all over the place and had no idea where you were throwing your line. So there is a trade-off there. You get a lot more accurate with this. There's actually two different ways to cast in this. There's one which I just told you about, where you hold the button down, and there is a actual cast assist as well. And once we land this fish, I'll show you the cast assist mode as well. But again, it's not as interactive as the other one is, but it's still pretty darn fun. And I'll trade off the quality of fishing in this game, the amount of species, the amount of lakes, the diversity that's involved in it. I'll trade all that for that little bit of interactivity any day of the week. So the fight on the fish, again, there's not as interactive as the other one was. You hold down your left mouse button to reel. And if I want to pop or tug or just kind of manipulate the fish a little bit, I use my right mouse button to pull back on the pole. And that gives me a little bit of a tug on it, like you would when you were trying to fish in real life. Another nice trophy bass there. I'm on a hot spot here. So before I cast out, let me show you the HUD real quick so you understand all the different things that are on my screen, because you might be wondering about them. Starting in the upper left-hand corner, you've got the time of day. You have the day of our trip. Now remember, I told you on a trip, I'm on just a one-day trip here. I could have it be 3 or 4 days long, but again, I'm only one day, so it's day one of one. If I was on a three-day trip, obviously it would be one of three or two of three. You've got the temperature outside. You can switch the game between metric or imperial. Of course, I'm in the States, so I'm using old Fahrenheit for the win. Cloud conditions, it's a little bit cloudy today. The wind's out of the northeast at 1 mile an hour. And if I wanted to see the help screen, which gives me my keyboard layout for the game and how to control everything, I hit F1 for help. And as you can see, it gives you a nice layout of all the different controls you can use. You see on the mouse that pitch, cast, reel is on your left mouse. pull, strike, aim, cast is on the right, and your reeling speed is on your center mouse button. So, a lot of information there. And it's right there, just a quick toggle of F1. If we move over to the right side of the HUD, you'll see that it tells me what kind of fishing lure I'm using. At this point, I'm using an artificial lure. Like I said, I'm using a bucktail jig, bass jig, 1/6 of an ounce. It's a number 2 hook on it. And yeah, so I'm going to cast it on out there. And I've got the number 4 at the top of them tells me how many I have in my tackle box. At this current time, I have 4 because I lost one just a minute ago. It's a sad, sad situation. Anytime you lose a piece of tackle to a tree. Down below that is all my casting information. The power bar there serves two functions. When you're casting, it's your power for how much cast you're going to give. When you are reeling in, it serves as a drag component to tell you how much tension is on the line. If it gets up into the top and gets really bright red, you run the risk of breaking the line and doing a little bit of damage to your equipment. If it gets all the way down to the bottom and this bottom little tip of it turns yellow, that means the fish is coming towards you. If it turns red, it means your line has gone really slack and you run the risk of letting a fish off. Not that you can lose a fish in the game, and I'll get into that later on. Next to that is your line distance. The big zero tells me I'm real tight right now and nothing's out. That'll change as soon as I cast. And then the bottom number is how much line I have on my spool. Below that, the circle is the amount of tension on my drag. If I increase the drag, you notice I get a lot more little dash marks around the circle. If I decrease my drag, it goes back down. And the center is the speed in which I reel. The more arrows, the faster you reel. If you flip it where it goes shallow and it's got a little open center in it, it actually reels backwards and lets line out. Just kind of like if you were on a spinning rod or whatever in real life and you flip that little lever on the back of it and it would let you reel backwards. But that's what that is. And I threw a cast out without showing you guys the other one. I do apologize for that. That was kind of a mistake on my part. All right, so another fish on. And again, I set the hook with my right mouse button, and then I start reeling with my left. And when my fish gets real tight, if I want to break it, I just pop it with that right mouse button to kind of give it a little oomph, and then I can pull in my slack right after that. And another nice big trophy largemouth. Or not trophy, just regular largemouth. Alright, so the assisted cast that I was talking about. Basically, to switch into the assisted cast mode, I'm going to right-click on my mouse. And it's going to bring up this big highlighted column. I place it where I want to fish. And much like a golf game or whatever, when you click once to start the power, and then you want to get it to line up dead center in the middle of that little white bar there where you've got the little clear spot in the center of it. You want to hit that for the optimum cast. If you're shallow on it, you're going to be a little bit short. If you're farther on it, you're going to be further on it. And so I'll start off and I'll pop it again. And it's basically, that is a two-punch cast in order to make that work. First click starts the power, second click actually makes the cast for you. So pretty easy to do. Like I said, it's not as interactive as that other game is, but I'm telling you, the action and the fishing in this is 10 times what it was in that other game. I absolutely love this game, and I think you are too. And like I said, it is in closed beta right now. Very soon it will be going into open beta, and you guys are going to get a chance to experience it for yourself. And I believe you get your hands on it, you're going to get addicted to it, because it is pretty darn fun. The fact that you can catch more than one species of fish is great. Like I said, they've covered the gamut in this thing. There's pike in it. I do believe I saw some walleye. And they just look on expanding the game. I was talking to a gentleman last night who really seems to be in the know on the game, has been talking to the developers quite a bit, putting a lot of feedback into the game. They just have all kinds of visions for this game. They're going to add in a Texas lake very soon. They're going to add boats into the game for certain lakes. My understanding is eventually down the road there might be some saltwater fishing in it, which would be amazing for me as I live on the Gulf Coast and would love to see some of that added into the game. So, fishing styles. I've covered species and all that, the economy, how to cast, everything else. What I didn't show you is the fact that you not only can fish artificial baits, you can fish live baits as well. And you have a whole lot of fishing poles. I'm going to switch over to a live rig that I have. Let me look. I've got a live rig here. And what am I missing on it? It doesn't have a hook on it. So let's put a hook on there. And let's put a little bait on here. So you guys can see how to use the inventory system real quick. I've got a backpack full of gear, as you can see. It's got all this stuff in it. And for live bait, I've got some night crawlers and I've got some small minnows. We're going to throw some small minnows on. We're going to fish for a little, crappie here. So I'm going to switch over to my live bait reel. All right. And you can see I've got small minnows. I'm using a number 10 hook. And I've got 12 minnows left in my inventory. I got a little float on here. We're going to adjust the length of our float by hitting the O or the P key. And I can adjust how many inches of leader I want between the float and the hook. I'm going to go for 36 inches. I think 3 foot's a good on a cloudy day. On a clear day, I'd go even deeper than that. I might go 4 or 5 foot on a cloudy day. But I'm fishing for crappie. And remember, crappie don't fish down. They only look up. So if you get too deep on them, they're not going to come to you and eat. They're going to always fish up. They don't fish down. So, all right. So I'm going to throw this out there. So I'm going to switch in my casting mode. I'm going to try and get right in between these trees here with it. And throw it out and let it float in the current. There is actually on this particular lake, there are some glitches still in this game. If you're not standing in the right spot sometimes, your casts don't necessarily work right. And let's give this another go. See if we can get it out there. There we go. All right. I'm going to reel that in a little bit so it's sitting in between these two trees. Well, what I was about to say about the current is I'm actually fishing on this map is a river. So the main channel of it comes around this side of this little island that's in the center. And it actually will drift my bobber down the water just a little bit. So there's two representations of my bobber right now. I can visually see my bobber out in the water. But over on the right, you see a little representation of it. And when it twitches, I'll see it move around. And basically what you want to do is you want to wait until it goes way underwater or it starts pulling either to the right or the left before you strike. And if you strike too soon, you'll miss the catch. And if you wait too late, you'll miss the catch. So you just kind of got to watch it. Just like in real life, you just kind of let it do its thing. Don't mess with it. Resist the urge to tug it on up. There we go. Now we can take it. And I got a fish on. And I need to adjust my drag a little bit. And let's see what we got. And again, I'm just doing a simple little tug and reel. And that, kids, is a unique black crappie. Remember I told you there was different types of fish in the game. You've got your regular black crappie, trophy, and that's a unique for us. So, very nice. Big, 2.8 pounds. Very nice. A lot of XP for that fish. So definitely going to keep it. And we'll cast out there again. Now, remember I told you you can pitch or you can cast? if I hit F11, I go into pitch mode. And just to demonstrate that, I just hold it and it just pitch it right out in front of me like so. Now there's no structure right there, so I obviously don't want to fish there. So I'm just going to reel that back in. But again, I just wanted to show you the difference between cast and pitch mode. And so we'll just kind of aim for the side of that tree right there. And again, the cast didn't work completely right. And again, the game's in development. There are some bugs in it that have to be worked out. I was fishing for brown trout the other night, and there's a rock formation and a there's a little rock formation and some logs that you fish next to. And if the trout gets over there next to the logs, it pops up out of the water and starts spinning around like a lasso. It's just kind of glitched out, but it's things like that are the reason they have closed betas, is so folks can find those little bugs, let the developers know about it, and by the time it goes into open beta, a lot of that will be fixed. I have snagged my line, so I've got to increase my drag a little bit and see if I can pull off of that. Now, here's one thing I don't like about the game. If you notice, when I pulled up right then, there was a little icon of a fishing reel that was kind of yellow. If I do again, it will probably reappear. See that? I'm doing damage to my reel, according to the game, by trying to clear off of this snag. And eventually, I'm going to break my reel by trying to do this. See, my reel was broken. I'm sorry, people, but that's not real. I don't care what kind of fishing reel I'm using. In real life, I wouldn't break my reel trying to clear a snag like that. Because in real life, what I would do is I would reel down on it. I'd tug on it a little bit. If I couldn't free it up by doing like a whip motion, if that didn't pull it up, I would not reel in, tighten my drag all the way down, and then pull back like so to try and free it up. What I would do in real life is I would reel down on it to where my rod is facing straight at the obstruction that I was on. And then I would take my rod and I wrap my hand around my rod and my line, and I would pull straight back on it, either breaking the line or straightening the hook, one of the two. I'm not going to damage my reel, so I really don't like that aspect of this game. If I snag up on something, and I would be able to free my line without doing that. So I just broke my reel. Now I've got to switch out reels. So I've got one. So you'll see there's a little repair icon on it, which means that reel's no longer good. Luckily, I have a spare in my backpack, so I can change over to it. I have to redo my hook. And I've got to put some bait back on there. But again, that part of it's a little unrealistic. The only time I'm going to break a reel in real life fishing is if I took too light of a reel to fish for too big of a fish. For instance, if I will periodically take ultralight tackle out on my boat, and we will go out and we will fish for certain species of fish on ultralight tackle. If I catch a big, huge, let's say ling or Spanish mackerel, that's really big, maybe I hook a king on ultralight tackle, it's going to strip the reel. I mean, it's going to strip the gears in the drag, and it's going to break something. It's going to break a spring, or it's going to break a tension pin or something like that. Anything else is not going to break my reel, but I'm asking for it by taking too light of a tackle after too big of a fish. If I snag on something, the line's going to break, or the hook's going to straighten out before you're going to break your reel and do any damage to it. The only people that break reels on snags are stupid people. I'm just saying that. So that aspect of the game, I really don't like. I just think if you're smart enough to go fishing in this situation, you wouldn't break your reel on a snag. You would be able to free the snag up. You might lose your tackle You know, you'd lose your tackle, but you wouldn't lose the rest of it. And why do I automatically have damage on this reel? This reel has not even been used, and yet I've got damage on it, supposedly. So a little bit glitchy in that aspect. Or actually, that's just a little bit of the gameplay that I don't like. I don't like that you're damaging a reel with something that you would not normally do in real life. Again, I would have my, like I said, if this was my rod and I was actually out there fishing, I would have it straight like that. And I would pull, I'd grab hold of the rod and the line, and I would start pulling straight back, walk back, whatever I had to do, until either the line snapped, or the hook straightened, or the obstruction gave loose. One of the three is going to happen before I break my reel. So that aspect of the game is just a little bit off. So thought I'd point it, but it's not really expensive to repair the reel. It's like $11 to repair a reel, depending on the quality of the reel. So, and speaking of quality of the items, we'll jump in the store in just a little bit, and I'll show you the interface on how to purchase items and things of that nature, and then I'll show you the quality of the items. There's two different types of items in the store. You can have your standard reel that is, you know, going to do the job for you, like the one I'm using right now. Or you can have a more premium reel. It's better quality. It's got, you know, maybe a little more ball bearings in it. Has a faster gear ratio to it. Something like that. Premium items, they cost gold. Where your standard items that are more less durable and not quite as good, they cost cash. So, again, that's the reason why there's two types of currency in the game, gold and cash. The cash is going to be for your less durable, you know, less reliable items. The gold is going to be for your premium, more highly desired items in the game. So, and I think what we'll do is we'll jump into the store right after this, and I'll show you all of that, because like I said, I don't want to do a whole fishing trip. I just wanted to give you guys enough action to let you go ahead and see the game, see how it's played out fishing-wise. I will cut some other video in here for you as well, of maybe a little bit of rainbow trout fishing, so you can see that as well towards the end of the video. And that way you can see it's not just about bass fishing. It's not just about crappie fishing. So, but anyways, let's go ahead and reel this in, and we'll end this trip. I'll show you what it's like when you end a trip, and we'll move into the store. So to end the trip, I just come over here to my escape out to my main menu, and this little globe with the little return signal, that's back home. I'm going to click it. It's going to ask me if I'm sure I want to leave, and then it's going to give me a synopsis of what I did. Now, I made $215 fishing with all the fish that I had. I also made 16 gold coin, because remember, unique fish, which I did catch one, gives me a little extra gold coin. So if I look down here, you'll see that unique black crappie gave me 16 gold coin. So that'll add to my tally. And you'll see I also got 428 XP for that little bit of fishing. One last synopsis page also tells me what my travel costs were. It cost me $150 to come to this lake. My daily fishing expenditures was $20. So when I compare that to what I made, I didn't make a ton of money, but I made a little bit. Now, normally, I wouldn't stop fishing this quickly. I would normally fish the entire day, but I did a short trip just to show you guys how the game is played. Wear and tear. Now it comes to me and tells me, oh, you broke a reel there doing something stupid. Do you want to fix it? Yeah, I need to fix that. And repair costs $13. So it will prompt you at the end. All right, this is going to get us to the main screen of the game, and this is where you're going to start out at. Now, as a beginner fisherman, you're going to start off in Missouri. It's going to be your home state, as they say. There is the ability to change states. I'm not sure if it's built into the game yet, but eventually you'll be able to come into the detailed look of a state and down here set as home state, but I believe it's not functioning right now. But from this menu, you can see each of the fishing locations. When you first start, this will be the only location you have. After you've fished and you level up, then you'll be able to fish New York, then you'll be able to fish North Carolina, Colorado, Oregon, Florida, and then finally California, where you can go after the salmon, Chinook. You'll be able to go after salmon, pike. There's the steelhead, trout, a lot of different fish out in California. Oregon lets you go for pike as well as trout, bass, crappie, and panfish. Colorado, a lot of fun. You go for trout mainly, but there are some crappie and some panfish there. New York has pike, as well as the walleye, like I said, crappie and panfish. North Carolina, pike, bass, catfish, crappie, panfish. And then when you get down to Florida, it's bass, catfish, and the panfish. All of this information that I'm showing you, keep in mind, this game is under development and things change. More species will be added along the way. More lakes are going to be added. I do know Texas is under development right now. They're building a lake for Texas. So just because this is all I'm showing you right now, keep an open mind and know that it's continuously evolving and new things will be added every day. All right, so from this map, I'll just give you the basics of it. Over here on the right, you see kind of a picture of where you're at. You get the weather for the next 5 days. You get a listing of the species that you have. And next to that, there's a little red icon on this one. That's a fishing license for that. If it's red, I don't have a fishing license. If it's yellow, it's running out. If it is green, I'm good to go, I believe. Yeah, if it's green, I'm good to go. If it's yellow, it's near expiration for me. So as you can see, I've got fishing licenses. Or maybe yellow just means I need one, or there's a specialized license for that specific fish. Not really sure on the color codes. I was thinking maybe it was expiring, but I've never bought an advanced fishing license for any of these fish, so I don't know why it's in yellow for me. That's something I'll have to look into and we'll cover in another video. But you can see, I can see the basic information on the fish. And then down at the bottom, I get my travel expenses. Think about the travel much like you would in real life. If I was in my home state of Missouri and I was going to run to the big lake that's about an hour away, I've got a little gas expenditure, some food, things like that. Maybe I've got to pay a boat launching fee, or I've got to pay a permit fee to fish that particular lake. So you've got your travel expense, and then you've got your fishing expense for each day you're there at the lake. Now, your travel expense for your home lake is going to be a little less expensive than it is to say to go to another lake that's further away for you, because you're going to have to drive further, or you're going to have to take a flight, something else like that. It's not like popping in the truck and headed an hour into town to go down to the lake. It's going to be a little bit more expensive for you to travel there. But your fishing expenditures per day are just about the same. They're pretty close. They're usually $10 to $30 per day when you fish. So, and again, you'll see your licenses that you need to do. And licenses you purchase in the store. And you can purchase a day, 3 days, a week, a month. You can do unlimited. I'll get into licenses in just a bit. But what I will advise you to do when you're fishing, and this is coming back to the tips I was going to give you on your travel expenses. When you buy the licenses to go fishing, your licenses are for a day in real life. So for 24 hours. If you buy a one-day fishing license in-game to fish all the fish in Missouri, that one-day license is going, well, let's not use Missouri, let's use Colorado. If I'm going to take a trip to Colorado to fish and I buy a license for 1 day, that 1 day is for 24 hours in real life. So if I buy it Friday night at 7 o'clock, that license is good until Saturday night at 7 o'clock. So in that 24-hour window, I can fish in Colorado as much as I want to. So here's my little tip for you on how to save some money on your travel expenses. When you get ready to go, set your trip for 3 or 4 days. And that way, you only eat that $203 the one time when you travel into there. Now, why does that matter? Well, when you're fishing and you're catching fish and you've got your fish stringer, when you start out, your stringer is going to be kind of small. You're going to fill it up pretty quick. And the only way you can unfill it is to go sell it. And the only way to sell it is to end the day. So my tip to you is go fish on like a 3 or 4 day trip. Then what you do is the first day you're there, you fish a little bit, you catch all the fish that you have for that particular day. Fast forward time, which is the T button on your keyboard. Fast forward until midnight. At midnight, all your fish are sold off and you have a nice clean stringer again. Then you can start fishing again. Catch a full stringer of fish. Fast forward time to midnight. Clear out your stringer and do it all over again. That way you're selling your fish, you stay at the same lake, and you don't have to eat that travel expense every time. If you do it one day at a time, and you jump in there, you fill up your stringer, you go sell your stringer for $500, but you got to travel back there again, that's $203 every time you travel back that you're eating out of your expense. Where if you make a 4 day trip, you pay that $203 the one time, and then you just fast track time to midnight, sell off your $500, sell off your next $500, sell off your next $500, and at the end, you make, you know, instead of paying $800 in travel expenses over four days, you only paid $203 in travel expenses. So that's a little tip that I'll give you guys, because when I first started the game, I thought the licenses were set up to where we'll jump into fishing licenses. When I looked at them and I saw one day, $25 in game, I thought, well, $25 isn't much. One day must be one trip, because a trip is a day, right? So I figured, oh, well, one day's license is one trip to the lake. And I thought, well, okay, I got to buy a license every time I go. No. The license is 24 hours in real life. So you buy that one-day permit, you've got 24 hours to go back and forth to that lake as much as you want. So to keep your travel expenses down, like I said, make a long trip and go over there and plan on fishing for a few hours. Fill your stringer up, sell it, fill it up, sell it, fill it up, sell it. Make as much money as you can make off of one trip, and that way you don't have as much expenses. Buy your unlimited license as quick as you can. You make money pretty good in this game. Now, they may tweak it a little bit, but if you can, you know, when you can afford it, buy your unlimited licenses, and that way you don't have to keep buying daily licenses or weekly or monthly. As you see, you have different structures for how many days you can buy your licenses. It's pretty straightforward. You just pick it, buy it, and each area is going to be a little bit different. So if I go to Colorado, for instance, Colorado has a basic license that I can buy. That doesn't sound right. Yeah, it has a basic license and an advanced license. Basic covers your, you know, crappie and panfish. The advanced covers the trout. Whereas if I go to North Carolina, there are three licenses for North Carolina. North Carolina has your basic license for your panfish and things of that nature. Advanced covers, I think, catfish and walleye or something, and then you have one that covers just smallmouth bass. So you have three different licenses that you have to get for there. And I do believe like California has a basic license, it looks like. There was somewhere else that I saw where you had to get three different licenses to fish. Maybe it was Oregon. Oregon had three different licenses. One specifically for trout. This one covered bass. This one covered your small pan fish. So each of them's a little bit different. So, but you know, like I said, the money's not ridiculous on them. $25 for 24 hours. That's a no-brainer. So you can do that. All right, so let's get into the menu system up here. I'll just blow through what you've been kind of going around it, but blow through the rest of it. So again, you've got your travel information over here, and you can see the basics of this. It's not bad. It's pretty good for you. All right, so your menu structure up at the top. You got your settings, my level. I'm level 14 at this point. This is my map. Home shows me what kind of gear I have, and this is just a representation of my little dude. Notice he's got the stylish baseball cap on, a little fishing vest, got a little tackle box, a fishnet, a pole bag, and then the different poles that I have going for me at this time. So as I just thumb through them. And you can have several different poles. It all depends on your pole bag, how many poles you can take with you. So you start off with a two-pole bag. That allow you to take your basically your float pole, and then you can purchase an additional pole. You start out with the basics, and what you get when you start out in the game is you get this float pole, the reel, some line, a hook, a bobber, and some worms, and then the stylish baseball cap. And what else? You've got your pole bag over here that she comes with it, and that's about it. That's a pretty basic equipment that you get to start off with. Over here, let's continue on looking at this panel and then we'll move on. First here is my backpack or my tackle box, and my vest combination is basically what your backpack is. Down at the bottom here, you'll see the number of reels that I can carry currently is 6. I have 5. The number of line spools I can carry is 10. I have 4. And then the number of pieces of tackle I can have is 50. I currently have 49. The little home icon shows me all the materials that I currently have that aren't in my backpack. So these are things that are at my house, but not on me. And then this is my licenses that I currently have active for fishing. So I can just scan through. I can see they'll show me when they expire or which ones are unlimited. And going back to my home, there are subcategories here, so you can sort through if you've got a real long list of things, which eventually the more tackle you buy, the more congested this will get. You can actually go through it by each category. So hooks and bobbers, line, lures and baits, outfits and tools. So all that is available to you. I'm sure this little icon with a car in it, that's probably going to be boats or vehicles down the road. But right now there's nothing underneath there. So that's going to give you basic information about what you currently have. That's what's in your little home here. In the basket, that's the store. That's where we're going to go and purchase items. And like I said, there is a ton in here for you. You've got rods, reels, tackle boxes, lures, lines, hooks, all kinds of goodies. We'll just kind of take a quick walkthrough here for you. Under rods, you'll see all the different rods that are available to you. If I look at an item in the store, you'll see, just using this rod here, a picture of the item, a value that tells you what level you need to be to purchase that item. So the star and the number tells you what level you need to be to purchase it, the name of the item, and then down here, how much it costs to buy it. And you'll notice when we get into reels, let's go ahead and switch into the reels. You'll have different values based on what to buy. So here I've got 2 spinner reels. I've got a Windcast 1500 level 2, and I got a Mini Spin 1200 level 2. This one's $55 cash. This one is 4 gold coins. And remember what I said, the better the item, you have to pay coin for it. If I come down here and I look at the Prima down here, I've got this Aspire ML or whatever. Let's see, that's not a good comparison. The Windcast. Let's go Windcast and Prima. The Windcast, 2500. This is level 11. It's $45 to purchase. If you look at the description of it over here on the side, it's a 4.6 to 1 ratio. So your recovery is 23.5 feet per second or per crank. So that's going to give you how much, or inches, I guess that would be, not feet, but 23.5 inches per crank on it. And it's mono and braided, but it tells you your drag, the ball bearings in it, and then your weight and then your drags on the front. Now, if we compare that, and again, that's $45, we compare that to the Prima, you're going to see it's a bit different. It has a different gear ratio. It has a faster recovery. It has more ball bearings in it. It has a stronger drag. It's a level 11, just like this one. It's just a better reel. And that's the reason this one is paid for cash. This one's paid for gold, because this is a premium and this is just a standard reel that you can pick up. So that's the difference in cash and buying on gold when you're in the store. So we've got our reels, and as you can see, there's a ton of reels. If we sort it out by spin reels, you'll see you've got your different spinning rods, and they go all the way up to level 20. You've got the big fat boy here that is for heavier fish, for catching like your stripers and your salmon. Then you've got your casting reels. If you're a fan of bait casters, you got a wide variety of bait casters as well that you can use in here. All the way up to these nice big vortexes that are, 32.5 pound drag on them. So they're for catching those behemoths as well. So a good variety of equipment that you can use. You can see there's a lot in here for you. Lines, you got your monofil, your fluorocarbon, braided line, whatever floats your boat you can get. Got it in different diameters. So like if we go to monofilament, you'll see a variety of diameters as well as strengths. So you click, you've got your 8-pound test and your 150-yard spool of it, all the way up to, 25-pound test, 32-pound test. So, great selection of lines. Tools and equipment. This is where you're going to find your stringers, your tackle box, vest, rod carriers. Now remember, like I said, the very first thing you need to do when you get into the game and you level up, as soon as you hit level 2, you need to buy you a fish stringer. As soon as you get to level 5, you need to buy a keeper net. What's the difference in the two? A fish stringer goes through a fish's gills to keep it. The fish keeper is a net that you put your fish in. Well, the reason you want to get a fish keeper versus a fish stringer is you can cull fish out of your fish keeper where you can't off of a stringer. Once you put a fish on a stringer, you're stuck with it. You can't take it off. You can't release it. A fish that you put into a keeper net, you can release. So if you're out fishing, and let's say you're in a tournament situation, and you can only keep 5 fish, you want to keep your 5 biggest. Well, if you put them on a stringer, you got to keep the 5 that you stuck on there. Whereas if you have a keeper net, you put your 5 fish in there, you catch a 6th one that's really big, you can take out the smallest one that's in your keeper net, throw it away, and you can keep the bigger one. So that's the nice difference between a keeper net versus a stringer, is the ability to cull out fish so that you can keep the bigger high dollar ones. Because let's say you're in a fishing situation and you know, each one of them holds a certain amount of pounds. Well, let's say in this one, it's 35 pound. You've got fish in there and you're at 34 pounds of fish, but the next fish you catch is a unique, is like a unique rainbow trout. Well, are you going to keep 3 small rainbow trout that are going to give you a little cash, or are you going to keep that unique rainbow trout that's going to give you gold coin? I'm going to keep the gold coin, so I'm going to throw out those other 3 fish and keep that one big fish. So that's the reason you want to get a keeper net versus a stringer whenever you can. So my big purchases for me, as quick as I could, I got my stringer. As soon as I got up to 5, I got the stringer long, because I didn't see a whole lot of a difference between the two of these. Because at that point, I went ahead and went with the stringer long. In hindsight, I might have gone with the keeper net small. Knowing what I know about trips and how to manipulate the trip system where you fill this thing up and then just fast forward to midnight and it becomes empty again, I just go with the stringer long. Either way, you're fine. But then the difference in the two of these is the weight of the fish that you can put on it. And that's the only thing that really matters between this guy here and this guy here. This one's 35 pounds total. This one's 31 pounds total. But the size of the fish that you can put in it is what's different. This one, the maximum fish you can put in there is 4.5 pounds. Well, if you're fishing for fish that get up around 6 or 7 pounds, you'd rather have this guy here because your max fish weight is 11 pounds. And that's the reason I went with this one over this one at level 5. But then now I'm using this Fish Keeper X Big, which is 15 gold. But look, you can put 440 pounds in this thing. I've yet to be able to fill it up. And I fish, like, I can fish all day and not fill that thing up. So it's an awesome net to get. Now remember, there is durability on these, so over time they will degrade. You'll either have to repair them or buy a new one. Tackle boxes and vest, the smaller level they are, the less they can hold. This one's 5 tackles and 1 line. Then you get up here to this one, it's 20 tackles and 3 lines. This bag holds 30, this one holds 50. So again, you've got different varieties of tackle boxes. Then we get into terminal tackle. That's your hooks, bobbers, things of that nature. And right now the selection in here, not too much, but it's enough. You've got all kinds of varieties of hook sizes, number 10s down to number 2s. The bigger, for those of you who don't know, the bigger the number, the smaller the hook. So if you have a number 10 on, you're fishing for crappie, panfish. If you want to prevent them from being able to suck your bait in, you switch to a bigger hook, which is a lower number, like a number 6, all the way down to a number 2 if you're fishing for some bigger fish, big largemouth, things of that nature. And then different stick bobbers. You can get whatever floats your boat as far as those. I'm used to using these old ball bobbers. You know, we used these forever when I was a kid. Growing up. And let's see, that's your terminal equipment. They are going to add sinkers in eventually. I was talking to one of the guys last night because one of the things I would love to be able to do is a Carolina rig where you move your sinker up a little bit from your worm. They don't have that in the game yet, but they are going to add that in. So like I said, they're thinking of everything, and they really are going to be working to make a great game. They're getting it functional, playable, and bug-free right now, and then they'll proceed to add more things into it. So lures, tons of lures. You've got spoons, casting spoons or blades, blade spinners as I call them. Then you've got your bucktail jigs that I was telling you about. Jig heads here for your grubs, crawfish, tubes, things of that nature. So jig heads here, they come in a variety of weights and sizes. This is a 16 ounce number 2. This is a 1/4 ounce number 1. You've got your 1-inch shad. We go to the next page, you'll get up to 2-inch shad, 2-inch tubes, 2-inch worms. You've got them in motor oil. Well, actually, you call them watermelon in here, but you got your different colors that you're used to, your whites, yellows, reds, motor oils, everything, chocolate, black. Everybody's got different names for them, but you know what I'm talking about if you've done any kind of fishing. There's all kinds of different worms out there. Larger spoons, as you level up and you get a different weight spoon, you get a 1/4 ounce spoon now or a 1/2 ounce, which just means you can cast further on the lake. More bass jigs for you that are a little bit heavier, a little bit larger, so you can catch those big trophy bass. Then you get into more jigs. Spinner baits, and then we start getting into some really good stuff. When we get up here on page 6, we start seeing crankbaits, look a lot like your Rapalas and things of that nature. So you got your crankbaits on here. So, like I said, they're expanding it. There's all kinds of baits, even live baits. You get into baits here, your naturals, your common baits like bread, worms, crickets, pet food, dough balls for if you're fishing for carp. You've got small minnows all the way up to cut baits. Even if you go into page 2 on this, you've got large minnows, frogs, crawfish, shrimp, leeches, whatever you want to use for bait, they've got it in here. They've really thought about a lot of stuff in here. So digging it. There's a lot of variety. And then finally, your licenses. So that's the store for you. And then we get into a summary of my character. It just tells you that all the different fishes I've caught, how many trophies I've got, how many uniques I've got, how many achievements I've unlocked. If we were in tournaments, it would tell you that. Your achievements are over here as you unlock them for doing certain things like unique ganger, catch 30 unique fish, or catch, at that point I caught 10 unique fish. Different achievements for you. Then your trophies, it shows you all your biggest fish per species. Big brown that I caught the other day, 7.1. My biggest unique rainbow. My trophy bass, those 5.2. So you're starting to see, you know, how you can go through and see what you've done in the game and what you caught it on. The next would be tournaments. That's not in the game. They will add that eventually. Leaderboard just shows you the information as far as the top players, what their ranks are as far as how many fish, you know, record fish are over here, leaderboards over here. This here is quest. Eventually, they'll give you some dailies to do. Then you've got a friends tab that doesn't function yet. And finally, club level, which I'm assuming club level is going to be like a premium membership that you can purchase, you know, with a little in cash, or a little cash out of your pocket. And then finally, what, you know, what currency I have. Currently 226 gold and 9,733 in money. I've been playing this game for about 2 days now, and so I've accumulated quite a bit of money fishing, so it's not too hard. Now, they could adjust the mechanics of the game before the final release, but you know, right now, it doesn't seem like it's too hard to make money in the game. As long as you play smart and you know, do things like maximize your trip so that you're not paying that travel expense every time. Go ahead and use your brain about what things you buy. You don't have to buy every piece of tackle. Now, I've bought a lot of tackle just because I go out and I wash a lot of tackle. I go out and I find a lake that I haven't, you know, when I'm new to a fish lake, I just start throwing tackle in the water and seeing what they're going to bite on, because I don't know. I know what would work in real life, but the game mechanics might be a little bit different. So I just start throwing things and figuring out what works. And you know, when I lock onto something that works, and when I locate the fish, then I fish them, you know, hard and heavy from there. So that's the basic overview, gameplay and everything else like that. I'm going to leave you with a little rainbow trout footage that I did earlier, and I hope you enjoy it, guys. I hope you like the video, and I hope you will stick with me. I'm going to do more and more episodes of this, maybe stream a little bit of it as well. So in the future, look for more videos on Fishing Planet. If you want to learn more about it, go to fishingplanet.com. Check out their website. You can find out a little bit more there. Also, I'll put the Facebook page down in the show notes, as well as the website and information how you can read the community forums and things of that nature for it. If you've got any comments or questions, go ahead and leave those below. Like the video and give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And of course, subscribe to this channel if you're new to watching my stuff. Of course, I encourage you to subscribe and come back. I do new videos every single day, and there'll be more on Fishing Planet. We'll come back. We'll do some actual, you know, fishing videos where we pick a location, we go to it, fish, and I'll show you some of the stuff as far as like manipulating time and, you know, how to do like a 3 or 4 day trip and use that as a way to catch a bunch of fish and make as much money as possible. So we'll do all that in our upcoming videos. Hope you've enjoyed it, guys. Again, it's called Fishing Planet. I'm Mr. Moose. Thanks for watching. I hope you'll come back and visit me tomorrow when my next new video comes out. Until then, stay safe, have a great day, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.